It's no good taking other shakti paths, not necessary, because the very kriya brings so much energy into your system, completes it. It's different, no? It's good to be in one path, in one energy, in one system. Then it grows in you, develops in one tradition. Respect every other thing, but do one thing. Otherwise your practice all gets muddled up. So many things mixed up. Kriya, and then do your meditation, simple meditation that you have been taught, that complements. See, some of the techniques are practices of Shaktipath, some of the practices of Kundalini, they create lot of anger in a person. There are certain techniques which are for recluses only, and there are certain other techniques which are there for people who want to fight, warriors. And there are certain other techniques which are there for calming down. So there are various type of things, and also system, your type of body, all these matters. You know, all that I want you to progress fast, very good. And so I am saying what would be best for you. I am not trying to keep you, okay, you should do only Sudarshan Kriya and nothing else. What I am saying is, this is the best for you if you want to be in the world. Okay, if you want to be alone in a forest somewhere else, then you can do something else. If you don't want to be in the society, want to be in a monastery, then I would recommend you something else. And if you don't want to be in the society or want to be a warrior, want to be in the war field, fight, then there are other type of meditation for you. So, if you simply pick up everything and mix, then what happens? It creates a lot of confusion in yourself. Do you see that? That is what is very important. Some of the Shaktipath, okay, you can take Shaktipath, but your energy gets intense and it will get turned into anger. And there are many masters I know, Shaktipath people, and they are very angry all the time about everything.